Hi, it's Katrina. From a monster with four tusks to a newly discovered fearsome predator, here are 10 of the most bizarre fossils and extremely rare ancient species discovered. Number 10. The four-tusked elephant. In 2014, a French farmer in a town outside Toulouse came across an extremely rare fossil. It was very strange and large, like a monster with four tusks. But the farmer didn't tell anyone about his discovery. Perhaps he didn't want the attention, or fossil hunters overrunning his property. Whatever the case, he kept the giant skull a secret. But a few years later, he had a change of heart and decided to phone the Toulouse Natural History Museum and report it. They came to check it out and were astounded at the significance of the skull. The bones ended up belonging to an extinct relative of the elephant that roamed France about 11 to 13 million years ago. Known as Gomphotherium pyrenaicum, this strange creature had a pair of tusks coming out of its lower jaw and two additional tusks coming out of its face like modern elephants. The lower tusks were flat and probably used to dig for roots to eat. The reason the History Museum was so interested is that this species of ancient elephant is not represented very well in the fossil record. Previous to the skull being discovered, only a few teeth had been pulled out of the ground in the last 150 years. The farmer found the only complete skull of this type of elephant, which museum curator Pierre Deleuze referred to as practically mythical. The next step for paleontologists is to extract the rest of the skeleton from the ground. An immediate search in the area did not reveal any more fossils, and it might just be that this is one of a kind. Number 9. Godzilla Shark. Scientists have finally named a 300 million-year-old fossil that they had previously been referring to as Godzilla Shark. The fossil was first discovered in New Mexico, and its teeth were so unusual that paleontologists realized they were looking at a very distinct species of animal. The ancient teeth didn't quite look like the arrowhead teeth modern sharks have. Instead, the teeth were squat and short, probably used for grasping and crushing prey instead of stabbing. This is according to John Paul Hodnett, the graduate student who first unearthed the fossil in Albuquerque back in 2013. All these years later, the shark has finally been officially designated as a new species. The Godzilla shark has been named Dracopristis hoffmanorum, which translates roughly to Hoffman's dragon shark. The name was chosen in honor of the family who owns the land in which the fossils were discovered. According to Hodnett, the area is rich with fossils and exceptionally easy to access because of a lot of commercial digging operations going on in the region. It actually took them 7 years of excavation before they could name the shark. They had to very carefully remove the layers of sediment from the 12 rows of teeth on the lower jaw of the shark, and that was only one of the tough jobs that took them nearly a decade to complete. As for the shark, it split from modern sharks and rays about 390 million years ago. These types of beasts went extinct about 330 million years ago, back when New Mexico was under the ocean. Number 8. Giant cloud rats. Giant rats don't sound good, but while you might be picturing creepy rats living in the sewers and lurking around your home, giant cloud rats are actually cuddly. Native to the Philippines, these giant rats are more like squirrels, living in the trees high up in misty mountain forests. But according to new fossil evidence, it turns out that these giant cloud rats have been living in the Philippines for much longer than previously thought. Scientists recently discovered the fossilized remains of three previously unknown species of giant cloud rats that once lived with our own ancient human ancestors. According to Larry Heaney at Chicago's Field Museum, the Philippines has the greatest concentration of unique mammal species anywhere in the world. Most of these animals are small and less than half a pound, and most of them live in the tropical forest. The recent extinct fossil species have revealed a biodiversity that was once even greater than it is today. The cloud rats that once lived in the trees of the Philippines were giants compared to the cloud rats of today. They weighed over 2 pounds and would have been more like fat tree koalas. They may have been so large that the ancient indigenous people of the Philippines hunted them all the way to extinction. This would explain why they disappeared abruptly several thousand years ago. Number 7. Ancient hedgehog. Fossil hunters in Germany have now discovered an ancient hedgehog. This isn't the most monstrous creature ever discovered by paleontologists, but it is exceptionally unique. Experts were excavating a pit of oil shale that had once been a lake formed out of a volcanic crater when they made the discovery. This crater has actually been designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site because of all the fossils found inside it that date back between 57 and 36 million years ago, a time when the Earth's mammals were developing at a blistering rate. The ancient hedgehog looked a bit different than how you might expect. It's true that the animal is definitely related to modern hedgehogs. So far, paleontologists have only found 7 prehistoric hedgehog fossils, making it rarer than most dinosaurs. Dr. Norbert Micklich from the Hessen State Museum, a man who himself has an impressive collection of fossils discovered from the volcanic crater, told local news sources that the find was extraordinary. Researchers were even able to identify the shape of the animal's hairs, thanks to fossilized bacteria left on the skeleton. The hedgehog was in such great condition that scientists will be able to take samples from inside the gut and see what the hedgehog ate for its last meal. Number 6. Tyrannosaur pack animals. A new discovery by paleontologists has revealed some shocking information. It turns out that one of the most feared dinosaurs in the history of dinosaurs may not have been a solitary predator. I'm of course talking about the fearsome Tyrannosaur. New fossil evidence has revealed that the Tyrannosaur probably operated as a social carnivore like a wolf. They hunted in packs and were probably smarter than we think. Paleontologists came up with the theory while excavating a mass Tyrannosaur death site that they found in southern Utah at the Grand Staircase Escalante National Monument. Using geochemical analysis of the fossilized bone and rock, specialists from the University of Arkansas determined that the Tyrannosaurus died in the exact same place and around the exact same time, suggesting an ancient society of Tyrannosaurs working together. But what's really fascinating is that according to ABC News, this is the 3rd mass Tyrannosaur gravesite that has been discovered so far in North America. More research still needs to be done to confirm whether Tyrannosaurs were really pack animals or not, but it's looking pretty good for the hypothesis. Some say that Tyrannosaurs definitely traveled together in rudimentary social groups, while others say they only came together when times got tough, using their combined strength to capture dwindling prey. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Number 5. The giant turtle. Fossils belonging to turtles that were bigger than cars have recently been found in South America. These turtles lived between 13 million and 7 million years ago, roaming throughout what is today Colombia and Venezuela. The fossils were discovered in both the Tatacoa Desert and the Urumaco region of Venezuela. According to the BBC, each turtle was the same weight and width of your average sedan. They lived in a massive wetland that stretched across South America before the Amazon River was ever created. But what did these giant turtles look like? Males had horns sticking out of their shells that were probably used like spears for fighting. The giant turtle likely lived at the very bottom of huge lakes and rivers, alongside some of the biggest crocodiles to ever live on the planet. But unlike the crocodiles, these giant turtles only ate little animals, loose vegetation, whatever fruit was available, and of course seeds. These turtles needed their immense size to fend off predators. The only way to fight a giant crocodile bigger than a car was to grow a shell just as big. Several of these turtle fossils were even found with giant crocodile teeth embedded inside of them. Number 4. The sea monster. The fossils of a very unusual sea monster have been puzzling paleontologists for over 100 years. The fossils are that of the Tanistropheus, something that resembles the Loch Ness Monster mixed with a prehistoric crocodile and crossed with an underwater giraffe. It was first described in 1852 and was reconstructed 120 years later in 1973. Paleontologists know that the sea monster once lived in what is today Switzerland, only 242 million years ago during the Middle Triassic period. The creature was roughly 20 feet long, with half its length made up of its ridiculously long neck. What scientists couldn't figure out is just why in the world this animal existed in the first place. What could a marine predator have needed such a long neck for? For that matter, scientists haven't been able to figure out if the animals even lived on land or in the water. It wasn't until recently that scientists used CT scanning technology to reconstruct crushed skulls dug out of the dirt. The results have proved once and for all that the sea monsters dwelled in the water and that they were indeed ambush predators. The Tanistropheus probably used its long and slender neck to slither up to their prey undetected, kind of like a sneaky water snake. Number 3. The Jurassic Pokemon. Scientists have found the amazing fossils of a brand new species of pterosaur, and they say it looks like a Pokemon. These fossils were found in northern China, and they date back to the Jurassic period. The pterosaur lived for a very long time in Earth's history, being some of the largest winged creatures on our planet from 252 to 66 million years ago. There were many different kinds of pterosaurs, ranging from as large as a sparrow to as huge as a giraffe. Pterosaurs were basically dinosaurs with wings. They even went extinct at the same time that the dinosaurs did. This newest species comes from 160 million years ago. It's been given the name Cynomacrops bondae. Fionn Wiesum Ma from the University of Birmingham worked extensively on the discovery. Ma told Vice World News that scientists examined the fossil using CT scans to study at least 100 anatomical characteristics before they could officially label it a new species. They say the creature was the size of a pigeon and had a mouth like a frog. It also had large eyes and huge wings with thick membranes. And as for its resemblance to a Pokemon, some people are saying that the pigeon-sized pterosaur looks kind of like a real-life Zubat, or maybe a Zubat mixed with a Pidgey. Number 2. The oldest octopus. Scientists from Heidelberg University in Germany may have just discovered the oldest known octopus in the world at an ancient dig site in Newfoundland, Canada. According to CTV News, researchers are saying the animal was probably the oldest ancestor of both squids and octopuses, making it the original cephalopod. Cone-shaped cells were found near Conception Bay. These fossils date back 522 million years. That's approximately 30 million years older than the first known cephalopod. This includes all classifications of squids, cuttlefish, and octopuses. What's truly fascinating is that experts have suspected for a long time that octopuses evolved much earlier from complex organisms. Until now, they never had any proof. But with these newest cephalopod fossils, experts can safely say that cephalopods originated at the beginning of everything, back when multicellular organisms first began to evolve during what is known as the Cambrian explosion. This was when life on the planet truly began to take shape. And it is fascinating to learn that cephalopods were at the forefront of this evolution. And it's even more amazing to think that over half a billion years later, these creatures are still among some of the smartest, most unique, and most highly advanced life forms on the planet. Number 1. The one who causes fear. A new and horrifying dinosaur has just been discovered in Argentina. It was a meat-eating predator that struck fear into the hearts of all the other dinosaurs. This is why scientists have named the creature the one who causes fear. Translated to the native Mapuche language, it's named Yucalcan aliocranianus. It was probably the top predator in Patagonia during the late Cretaceous period because of its massive size, its destructive bite force, razor-sharp teeth, fearsome claws, and its remarkable sense of smell. This dinosaur stood about 30 feet tall and prowled the southern subcontinent of Gondwana, while the Tyrannosaurs ruled to the north. But these southern predators were a bit different from their northern friends. They had short and stubby arms like the T-Rex, but they also had abnormally short skulls that were often covered in bumps and horns. Scientists also discovered special ear cavities inside of the fossilized skulls, suggesting that they had far superior hearing to other predatory dinosaurs of the time. Unfortunately for the one who causes fear, its time ran out just as it began to flourish. The fossil evidence suggests the dinosaur had been gaining sophisticated traits, meaning it was still moving down an evolutionary pathway to becoming an apex animal. Then that pesky rock smashed into the earth and it was game over. Thanks for watching! Which of these ancient monsters would have been the most terrifying? Which one was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to hit that subscribe button and come back soon. See you later! Bye!